بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم، الحمد للہ وکفا وسلام علی عبادہ الذین اصطفیٰ، اما بعد، قال اللہ تبارک و تعالی فی الکلام المجید والفرقان الحمید، بعد اعوذ باللہ من الشیطان الرجیم، بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم، یا ایہا الذین آمنوا اتقوا اللہ حق تقاته ولا تموتن الا وانتم مسلمون. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من كان اخر كلامه لا اله الا الله دخل الجنه. صدق الله مولانا العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم وصلى عليه. صدق الله مولانا العظيم و صدق رسول النبی الکریم و نحن علی ذلک من الشاہدین و الشاکرین والحمد للہ رب العالمین. اللہم صلی علی سیدنا محمد و علی آل سیدنا محمد و بارک وسلم و صلی علی. رب اشرح لی صدری و یسر لی امری و احلل عقدۃ من لسانی یفقہوا قولی رب زدنی علما. سبحانک لا علم لنا الا ما علمتنا انك انت العلیم الحکیم. مائی موسٹ رسپیکٹ برادرز اینڈ ایلڈرز اینڈ آنریبل سسٹر ناظرین، السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ. لیٹس برنگ اور ہارٹس اینڈ اور مائنڈز ان دا اسٹیٹ آف شکر، دا ہائیسٹ لیول آف بلیسنگ what any jinn and insan can enjoy, that the blessing of al-iman. I would say correct iman. Some people have not very correct iman. Example, we believe la ilaha illallah muhammadur rasulullah, they know birthday but worship but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the messenger. If the people don't believe he's the last messenger, that's not correct iman. That's incorrect iman. So we have to believe he's the last messenger. We should do shukr on that. This is the greatest ni'mah. Alhamdulillah, we enjoy this ni'mah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us birth in the mother lap who was Muslim. Otherwise, it's very hard to become Muslim. As a Hindu, very hard. Jew, very hard. Christian, maybe. So, we should do Alhamdulillah. When our idea comes to mind, I am Muslim, we say Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. This is a kalma shukr. La in shakartum, la azidannakum. If we do shukr on any ni'mat, any blessing, we want to increase that. We should do shukr on that. Even I always advise, sometime once in a week, we should make two rakat nafal shukr. Ya Allah, you blessed me with iman. It's very important, I'm giving you homework. It's good. You see, this is a word, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah. When we say this wording, we enter in Islam. When we bring the meaning of these wording from the heart, that become iman. Iman, we cannot show. Iman invisible. The place of iman is the heart of the mu'min. Then, according to iman, heart command to the body, the body take action. Imam strong, heart tell the body, go to make salat in the masjid. Recite Quran and Majid. Do good deed. And iman is weak, then heart will say, okay, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Ghafoor Rahim, He will forgive you. There's a trick from Shaitan. There's a trick from Shaitan and nafs. We should be very, very watchful. What is the sign of iman? What is the sign of iman? How can I test it? I have iman or not? Very simple. Okay, when we do any good deed, we feel exhilaration, mean happiness, special kind of happiness we feel in the heart. Example, you saw some poor person. You gave him $5. You donated money in the masjid. And we feel very happy. Though money going out of the pocket, right? We are unhappy when money lost. But now you're giving you money, empty your pocket, but feeling very happy, right? This is a sign of iman. You understand now? Many are good, we do any good deed. After doing good deed, we feel happiness. After Salat, we feel happiness. After Ramadan, we feel happiness. After paying the zakat, we feel happiness. So sometimes we have to pay $1,000 zakat. But we feel happy, sir, inside. Serving mommy and daddy, we feel happiness. Serving the poor, we feel happiness. This is a sign of iman. And when by chance a bad deed happened from us, then we feel ashamed, right? We feel sorrow. You understand now? Now you check yourself. There are certain ingredients of iman. Aamantu billahi wa malaikatihi wa kutubihi wa rusulihi wa yawmil akhirhi wa qadri khairihi wa sharrihi min Allah ta'ala wal ba'se ba'd al maut. We have to believe in all seven ingredients of iman. Aamantu billahi. We have to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's alone. Qul huwallahu ahad. Allahu samad. Lam yalid. Wa lam yulad. Wa lam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. We have to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's alone. Can control everything. Nothing can move. A leaf cannot move without his permission. We should believe 100% Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my deity. Worthy of worship. Aamantu billahi wa rasulihi. Then we have to believe. Aamantu billahi wa malaikatihi. Then we believe the angels. Jibreel alayhi salam, Mikael alayhi salam, Israel, all angels we have to believe. We can't deny any one angel. That iman will be not complete. Wa rasulihi. We should believe in all the anbiya. But we follow who? The last Prophet, Hazrat Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Aamantu billahi wa malaikatihi wa kutubihi. We believe in all books also. But yawm al akhirah and life hereafter. The person believes everything. Does not believe life hereafter. No, iman is not complete. It's invalid iman. And after death, we have to wake up again. And second part, the ziyat of iman is, Aamantu billahi kama huwa bi asmaihi. I believed all his beautiful attributes, his sifat. For example, he sami. He hears. Even one black ant in the mountain, black night, she little moves on the stone. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hears the voice of her legs. Understand? When we are two, he is third. When we are three, he is fourth. When we are four, he is fifth. He hears. He is Sami. Let me tell you, we don't have firm belief in this. If we have firm belief, we cannot do backbiting. Right? We cannot tell lie. He is listening. We cannot listen to songs. No. No. He is Sami. When he is Sami, I love to recite Quran and Majid. I will love to read to him. He is Sami. He is Basir. He sees where we are. Now, how person can commit adultery when he believes in that he is watching me? We cannot commit sin. He is watching us. You know, Yusuf alayhi salam, Zulaikha. Zulaikha locked him in. And he covered all statue with the curtain, with the cloth. And now he told Yusuf, come on. He said, you covered all these statues, your God, but for Allah, he's watching us. Then he ran from that room. That whenever we are stuck up any guna, what should we do? We should try our best to get out of that situation. Then Allah will help you. She locked the door. When Yusuf tried his best to run out of the doors, Allah unlocked the door. This is what it is. And we should accept from the tongue and believe in the heart. If we don't believe in the heart, he is not a mu'min. He is a munafiq. And munafiq status all the way down as far as safilin in the hellfire. So, we can revive, we can refresh our iman. Sawal se, Ya Rasulullah, kaifa nujaddidina iman? Rasul Akram said to Sahaba, jaddidu imanu, refresh your iman. Sahaba said, Ya Rasulullah, kaise? So, the answer was, aksaru min zikri la ilaha illallah. If we do maximum zikr of la ilaha illallah, it will increase our iman. You say kalma hai, tawheed, if you maximum zikr la ilaha illallah, I always advise, especially old people, listen carefully. Of course, nowadays, very young people can go anytime, yes or no? But especially old people, we are on the way. I advise the old people especially. And when you become old, don't forget my advice. In old age, do more zikr of La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. And the zikr of istighfar. In the old age, or we are very sick cancer. So what should we do in that age, that situation? We should do maximum zikr of what? La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah. In the beginning, few times, full kalma tayyiba, then just say la ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, maximum. And do maximum istighfar. Now what will happen? When we do istighfar, our sins will be forgiven. You understand? By tawbah and istighfar. Astaghfirullah Rabbi min kulli zambin wa tubu ilayh. Or astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. Accept your sin. Yeah, accept the sin. I feel ashamed. I will not do again, Ya Allah. This is tawbah. We should do more tawbah in the life, in the old age. So what will happen then? Our sins will be forgiven. But here's one trick I tell you. Don't wait for Isha. If we commit, happen some sin, 12 o'clock, don't wait for evening, I will do istighfar. No, no. Do right away. Soon any sin happen, don't think about shaitan is a minor sin. Please. Any sin happen any time, we should do right away istighfar, keep the, make the record clean. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Kareem Rahim Ghaffar, He forgave right away. So through istighfar, we keep our record clean. And then we do zikr of la ilaha illallah. You know what will happen? At time of death, wuzu not required. Don't worry. That's why it is said, when a person is very, very sick, you should do talqeen. You know what is talqeen? Sit beside the sick person. Don't tell him, say la ilaha illallah. You start saying la ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah, la ilaha. Start saying this. You know what will happen? He listen, and he will start saying la ilaha illallah. Don't tell him. He may say no. You understand? Because he's the pain of the disease, whatever it is. This is called talqeen. And one person say la ilaha illallah at the time of death, what will happen? Hadith Pak says, man kana akhir kalamihi la ilaha illallah dakhala jannah. Whose last sentence will be la ilaha illallah, entering the? Now there are two ways to go to Jannah for Muslimin, for Mu'min, for us. Forget about kafir. May Allah give them hidayat. All non-Muslims, we should make prayer. Ya Allah, your Jannah is very busy. Please give them shahada, give them iman. Let them enjoy Jannah al-Firdaus also. Why not? There are two ways to go to Jannah for a mu'mineen. One straight, one via Jahannam. Astaghfirullah. Who is via Jahannam? Who has still kabira guna, some guna pending. He did not do tawbah. That's why I told you the formula. Do tawbah. Understand? Right away. Anything happen. And then do zikr la ilaha illallah. So inshallah, soon we close our eyes. They put us in the grave. Door of Jannah will be open, inshallah. Inshallah. Do zikr of very, very, of course, zikr of durushi is very important also. When you are upset, pensive mood, something bad happening, do Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ala Sayyidina Muhammad. This will make your heart happy. Feel good. Inshallah? Yes. Some I more give you tips how to die with Iman. Because this is a hukam in the Quran Majeed. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Ya ayyuhal amanu taqullah haqqa tuqatihi wa la tamutunna illa wa antum muslimun. O believers, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't commit any minor sin. Do every available good deed. And wala tamutunna illa wa antum muslimun. Don't die, die as a Muslim. This is our purpose of our life. Purpose of life is not to have five cars, big building, lock of gold and silver, big jobs. Of course, that's not bad. They're asbab. But the The purpose of life is we should die with Iman. You understand now? Die with Islam. And the Quran says, don't die, but as a mu'min. There I will give you some tips how to die with Iman. You understand? Take this homework and tell your wife also. We should do sevak, miswak. Before wuzu, we should do miswak. The person who always does miswak with wuzu, at the time of death, angel will remind him, la ilaha illallah. Understand? Of course, he will be free from a lot of diseases of the teeth. Yes or no? So keep sevak with you. And brush, even if you don't have sevak, use brush and take out the meat. And then do sevak also. Inshallah. That angel at the time of death, they will remind la ilaha illallah. We should make recitation of Quran-e-Majeed. Quran-e-Majeed says, if we recite Quran-e-Majeed, your iman will increase. There are so many ways to increase iman. There is no one way. And so many ways to decrease iman. So one of the best also, we do recite Quran-e-Majeed. Our iman will increase. Then we should read the meaning. What we Quran part we read, we know the meaning of that part. More iman increase. Then we learn the tafsir. We should hear the tafsir by the ulama. You have the Mufti Sahib, mashallah. He gives tafsir every day. Read his schedule. Listen to tafsir. He does tafsir over here in the over his masjid also. Listen to his tafsir. Subhanallah. One of the best alim I ever saw. Of course, he's my teacher also. But still, I have to say it. Best tafsir he does. So you should listen his tafsir. Iman will more increase. Then put into practice. What he advised? Put into practice. Iman will more increase. Then give dawa. Give dawa. Of bil Quran. Subhanallah. Iman will increase. Invite the people toward the la ilaha illallah. Do work of dawa. Join such people who do work of dawa. Listen to them. Iman, inshallah, will increase. We should glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Maximum iman will increase. By sadqah khairat, iman will increase. Listen, we should internal and external. We should look at the mountain, look at the trees, look at the flower. Go to botanical garden. How many kind of flower, different color, beautiful, you will see there. You understand? It will increase your iman. How these flowers, same land, and the flower are different kind. They get the color from the moon, Allahu Akbar, and sun help them, subhanallah. Look internal part. And my wife or sister get pregnant. Who construct body inside? Think over it. Think over it. Doctor? We go to doctor only when ready. Before that, who made fingers? Nails, proportionately. Allahu Akbar. For heart. Hair. Hair over hair. These hair don't grow too much. These hair grow too much. These are signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 4 months, 4 months, 4 months, who come, subhanallah,